So I decided, let's try it. It doesn't hurt. So before we get started, go ahead and subscribe to the channel. Click the bell for notifications and give the videos a thumbs up and give me any other ideas that you guys may have. So what I'm going to do today is I'm going to tell you about a stalker story that I actually watch. What is a stalker TV series that I watch? So you guys grab you some popcorn, something to drink, and tune in. Okay, let me get some sip of my drink. Okay, so this particular gentleman is in prison, and his name is Daniel Thompson. So Daniel Thompson is on the autistic spectrum. Since he's on the autistic spectrum, he does not know how to deal with his emotions. So whenever someone hurts his feelings or he doesn't know how to process his emotions, he actually gets upset and he does violent type things in order to process how he feels. So when Daniel was about 17 years old, he liked this girl named Jennifer. Now Jennifer was 15. So he came over to her house, introduced himself, and told her dad basically that he wanted to date her. But the dad told him, "You're too old for her, so why don't you come back at another time?" Now any normal person would have just moved forward, but Daniel waited exactly 1 year to the date, came back to her house a year later, knocked on the door, and decided to date her because at this time she would have been 16 years old. So the girl Jennifer thought it was just like so cool or so sweet that he wanted to date her, that he literally waited a year. So some time goes on, you guys, and they're like hanging out with each other, they're having a really good time, but her dad noticed that he was over to the house just a little bit too much. And so the dad told him, "Look, you can come over on certain days and you can stay this long. And then once that time is up, you need to go back home." So he didn't really like that. Daniel wasn't feeling the restrictions. He had an issue with people telling him how to do stuff. This is so weird to me, you guys, whispering. I hope you can hear me. So what Daniel would do is he would sneak over to their house, you guys, and he would climb through their doggy door. He crawled through the doggy door, and he would go inside of Jennifer's room and sit by her bed or either stand over the top of her and say, so there was a few times, excuse me, that she woke up and saw him standing over the top of her. And in her mind, because she was 16, for some reason she didn't find that weird. She thought that meant he really loved her, that he couldn't be without her. He always wanted to be around her. So some years go by and they actually move in together. She has a couple of kids by him, but she noticed that when she moved in with him, that he became really possessive. It was to the point that he had weird things that he would do to her, like she couldn't sleep in the bed with him, so he made her sleep on the floor by the bed. And at some point in time, she kind of got fed up with it. She mentioned to him that she just wanted to leave him or what have you. So one day, she's carrying the baby through the house. He gets upset about something, and he begins to choke her. She has the baby in her arm. She says she just remembers the baby falling on the floor. And when the baby fell on the floor, she just remembers seeing all black. When she woke up, you guys, he was standing over the top of her. So she called the police. The police had came out to their house like a number of different times. Nothing really happened. It was what it was, just another domestic dispute. So she got to the point that he wouldn't let her leave the house. and come help her. So eventually, she got up. She mustered up enough courage to actually move away. But when she moved away, he came back, got inside of her house, you guys. She didn't know he was in there. But one day, she went down in the basement, and she found a bag. And inside of the bag was a shovel, rope, handcuffs, a knife, and some duct tape. He was waiting for the right moment to tie her up and kill her and bury her. So some type of way, I don't know what transpired with that. No, this is what it was. She had got a restraining order on him. And because the bag was in their home and they did like a DNA thing to test for fingerprints, they found his fingerprints on it, and that was enough to get him locked up. So they said that he was trying to, like, basically murder her but kidnap her at the same time, and he was breaking the restraining order. So he gets locked up for like 8 years. So she's relieved. She's going on with her life. He's in prison. Now, in his mind, he's saying that she provoked him to do it. How did she provoke you to do it? He said that she provoked him to do those things, and that he would never hurt her, that he was just trying to get her attention or make her love him again. So when he gets out of prison, he got 8 years for that. When he got out of prison, he linked up with a lady. He got in a relationship with a lady. Her name was Angie. And she had 2 children, you guys. So the relationship was going great at the time. He would get up and cook her breakfast. He would take care of the kids, all of those different things. But it continued to be the same cycle over and over again, where he would like be really obsessive. He would call her on the phone like numerous times when he would leave. He was just really taking over basically her life. So Angie decides to break up with him and get a restraining order as well. So she gets the restraining order, you guys. He's calling her. He's not supposed to have any form of contact with her. So she has him on a recording calling her like 5, like I think they said like maybe 200 to 300 times a day, blowing her phone up, telling her, I'm going to get you because you could pick up the phone. He was cussing her out, just all kinds of stuff. So Angie decided to go on the internet and meet a guy. So this guy that she met, I think his name was Donald. So one day, her and Donald, they had just met on the internet, and they slept together like the first, I guess the first day. No judgment here. So when they slept together on the first date, the guy, Daniel, came into the house, stood over them while they were sleeping, looked at her, looked at the guy, and shot the guy in the chest while they were in the bed together. Killed him instantly. So she runs out the house. He doesn't get hurt. She calls the police. The police come. They arrest him. He finally ends up going to jail after they arrest him. And when they put him in jail, they put him in there for like 35 years. But he started calling the first lady, Jennifer, from the jailhouse. Now, she wouldn't pick up the telephone. Of course, you have to accept the charges. She wouldn't pick up the telephone. He began to write her letters from the prison house. This guy wrote her letters every single day for months on end. He said he did it because he was so upset that she broke up with him, and she didn't like the fact that she took a restraining order out on him, and he didn't like anybody telling him what to do. So at the time that he stood over, now go back, when he stood over the guy to shoot him, when the lady lifestyle. So I don't know what that whole situation was, but he killed the guy. So finally, Jennifer contacted the jailhouse, and they made it where he could not have any contact with her anymore, or they wouldn't mail out his letters for him because he was trying to harass her. So when they interviewed him, when they interviewed him and talked to him, he just said he was upset about the whole situation. Now in his mind, he's living in like this land of delusion, because he says in his mind, I really don't think it's stalking. I mean, I did call her a couple of times, but I don't think it's stalking. 200 to 300 times, what the hell? That's stalking. Like, what don't you get about stalking? So he said, well, I was just trying to get her to talk to me. If she would have talked to me the first time, I wouldn't have called her anyways. And so they asked him, did he learn his lesson? And he said, well, yeah, I guess I did learn my lesson, but I don't think I'm gonna get a relationship whenever I get out of prison. So he is up for parole in like 2034, something like that. It's the first time that he could come up, he could be eligible for parole. So the family was upset because they felt like he should have got life and he should have never been eligible for any type of parole whatsoever. So that story was so bizarre, and the guy looked so weird. He looked like a little weasel, to be honest. And he swore up and down he wasn't harassing these women. You guys, so this is ASMR story time. Something new we're trying out. I don't know, I like this little whisper thing, y'all. So you guys, go ahead and subscribe to the channel. Why? Because it's absolutely free. Share the video. Give the video a thumbs up. Engage with